paleontologist, your field work often composed of two main phases. One being the prospecting phase, which is what I'm doing now, and the other being the excavation phase. So during the prospecting phase, the crew members spread out and try to look for any exposed fossils. So we look down and walk for miles and miles. So during the prospecting phase, the tools we generally use include scratch owl, so you can pick out a rock or a fossil. Such a brush to brush away surrounding sediment gently. And then we have geologist's best friend, the rock hammer, to remove more rock, but definitely less gentle than with a brush. And some of the other things we bring include a specimen bag, so we can put sort of smaller specimens that we find walking around, and then show it to the other crew members. And of course, our field notebook. So it's got illustrations of the site that I was working on in the last 2 days, and then some GPS coordinates, so we know where we find each of the specimens. And then last but not least, we also carry around a GPS device so we don't get lost. You can definitely get carried away just looking down and walking, so it's good to keep GPS handy so that we don't get lost. I found some bone fragments, which you see all over this locality. And so paleontological fieldwork almost always involves finding these fragmentary bones, these shattered bones, and are almost never like how it was depicted in the film Jurassic Park, where you see a complete skeleton of a dinosaur buried underground. And we also don't use sort of some seismic devices to look for fossils, because the resolution, at least with current technology, is not good enough to locate precise locations of fossils. So we just rely on our feet and our eyes to discover new fossils. And so you see a lot of chunks of bones like these in this small section of this butte. Let's keep climbing up, follow these bones. So these bones are pretty unidentifiable. A lot of them are from limb bones. But beyond that, it's hard to tell what the bones are and to which dinosaur it belongs to. Oh, there's some more bones. Okay, these are bigger chunks, but these are still fragmented. So this might be coming from a femur or your thigh bone. But again, it's somewhat difficult to tell from these chunks. But one thing that you can be sure of is that it came from a pretty large animal, maybe from a tyrannosaur, Aleoramus, which was discovered by A&H team a few years ago. One of the tricky things in paleontological fieldwork is making sure that you actually have a fossil. So here on the ground we have a nice looking tooth row, but this is from an animal that, actually a mammal, probably a camel, that died very recently. And it's been picked probably by other animals and scavenged. Initially, it does look like a fossil, but you can see that it's still made up of the original biological composition of bone. It hasn't undergone through a fossilization process, which involves a replacement or the of the original composition of the bone, or the invasion by additional minerals that seeps into the bone. So since it hasn't gone through those processes, this is not a fossil. We're looking for things that are millions of years old. In our case, over 60, 70 million years ago.